A strange series of disappearances is gripping the state of Vermont, disappearances which involve incorrect grammar. In places and names around the state, apostrophes are vanishing. For example, there is no longer an apostrophe in Sexton's River in southeastern Vermont or Mallet's Bay on Lake Champlain. Why? News Channel 5's Anya Hunneke has the story.
What's in a name? Or sometimes a better question, what's not? The answer can differ depending on where you go.
I spell it C-A-M-E-L apostrophe S.
In Vermont, you can hike up Camel's Hump with an apostrophe, or Camel's Hump without one. You can go shopping in Taft Corners, Taft's Corners, or Taft's Corners in Williston. Or you can take a boat ride in Mallet's Bay in Colchester, the site formerly known as Mallet's Bay with an apostrophe. Across the state, the little punctuation mark has been disappearing, and apparently the trend is nothing new. Historian Stephen Nissenbaum, an adjunct professor at the University of Vermont, says it dates back more than a century to a move by the federal government aiming for more efficiency.
This federal agency designed to standardize local place names dictated that apostrophes would be dropped.
Change, however, has been slow in Vermont and across the country.
Some towns have kept the apostrophe, some towns have removed it, some communities around the country, for whatever reason, such as Martha's Vineyard, who successfully fought to keep their apostrophe.
They've fought, Nissenbaum says, because removing the apostrophe is technically incorrect, and it removes the possessive in, for example, Saxton's River, named after a surveyor who, legend has it, fell into the river and drowned.
If you lose the sense of the fact that Saxton was a person and that that was Saxton's River, then it becomes simply a name.
Removing the apostrophe can also change the meaning, as Patty Delaney has found living on Camel's Hump Road in Duxbury.
Without the apostrophe, it would be another meaning, like camel's humping.
Some grammarians may take issue with the missing apostrophes, but chances are techies won't. After all, everything is abbreviated these days on phones and computers, so why not on maps too?
The number of people who stop and care is probably diminishing rapidly.
As are the apostrophes, making a century-long journey off the map. In Taft, Taft's, and Taft's Corners, Anya Hunneke, News Channel 5.